A survey report is a way of organizing raw response data to make it easier to analyze. A properly constructed survey report will let you quickly and easily share survey results with your team, analyze data in your spreadsheet software, and will provide graphs and bar charts for your next customer feedback presentation. I'm Sabina, a content manager at Survicate. In this video, we're going to go through what's inside a survey report, how to understand and filter that data, as well as some additional reporting options, all within the Survicate software. You can think of a survey report as a document with the most important metrics gathered from feedback. For any survey you create with Survicate, you will get your results all in one place, in the Analyze tab. You can access that really quickly from your survey library by clicking on the Responses, or simply selecting the Analyze tab in your survey view. Any results you collect will populate in real time. So let's have a look at the contents of a Survicate survey report. Here you can see the amount of responses you received. You can hover over the bars to get some more details. The data will be displayed on a graph, so you can see the dates you received those responses. And you can change the view from daily to weekly, monthly, quarterly, or however long you've been collecting feedback. You'll also see a completion rate, and Survicate also collects answers to partial responses, so you will still get data even if customers don't answer all of the questions in your survey. Here you can see the date of the last response, and it is given in a UTC time zone. And also you get the total views of your survey. If you create website or in-product surveys, you'll also see the total number of unique views of your survey. You'll likely be most interested in your response content, which is the actual answers your customers provided to your questions. But let's have a look at these metrics really quickly to see what they tell you. The number of responses will tell you how many people answered your survey or how many responses you received. That will let you assess whether you have enough data to properly analyze your survey results and whether you've reached your sample size. The completion rate is the number of questions answered divided by the total amount of questions in your survey. For example, if you have a survey of 12 questions, but most people only answered 6, your completion rate will be about 50%. If the percentage is low, you may have to work on removing irrelevant questions to avoid survey fatigue. You'll also have the date of your last response. And the most exciting part, your customers' answers. How this information is presented depends what kinds of questions you included in your survey. Survicate offers 13 question types, and let's have a look at what the most popular ones will look like in your survey report, starting with closed-ended questions. Single chosen drop-down questions will look more or less like this. And to calculate the results, we divide the number of responses to a particular answer by the number of total responses provided for this question. And then we multiply by 100 to get a percentage. Multiple answer selection questions are a bit more complicated to calculate, but the data is still pretty easy to understand. The bar chart will show you how popular a given option was in terms of actual responses. And obviously, the longer the bar, the more popular this given option was. Ranking questions, rating scale, and smiley scale questions will look more or less like this. And they also provide quantitative data. This is a customer satisfaction question. You want the needle pointing as far right as possible, obviously. And then the bar chart also shows you your results distribution. And a smiley scale will look almost identical. Let's also have a look at the NPS question, which is a very popular one. It's always something along the lines of how likely is it that you will recommend our product to a friend or colleague. And you get your NPS score right here, and you get your bar chart to show you your distribution, but you also get this division into promoters, passives, and detractors. Text answers, on the other hand, generate qualitative data, which is a bit harder to analyze. Luckily, Survicate generates a word cloud for you, so show you the most used words within those answers. If you design your questions well, the analysis can be very quick. So let's have a look at this question, for example. What should we improve? And the most popular words used in the text answers were agent, service, customer. So customer service is probably an area you should work on. And we have another question with a text answer. What is the biggest value you get from using our product? The words we see here will represent an area we are doing well in. So we have options, results, customization, customizing. Obviously, customization options are something these customers enjoy. And if you ever want to exclude any words, you can just start typing them down here. And once you press enter, the word cloud will regenerate. Of course, you will need to get enough responses to generate a word cloud. You can also analyze each response separately in the individual responses tab. This is helpful to see trends in your users' responses. You may even be able to gather user attributes. And if you integrate with particular tools like Google Analytics or Intercom, you'll be able to capture demographic data and then contact the respondents individually. You can also filter your survey results to narrow down the amount of data you're looking at once. You can also find a respondent that matches your criteria or analyze the chosen time period independently. Survicate allows you to filter by many attributes, such as your question, a provided answer, the name of the respondent, their email, and so on. Simply click here to add a custom filter and choose your desired criteria. For example, let's just say we want to see all the customers that were unhappy with our product. It's between 1 and let's say 2. So now the report is only showing responses from customers who are unhappy with the service or product. I highly recommend you connect Survicate with some other tools you are already using, and we have many integrations. When it comes to survey results, the most helpful ones will probably be Google Sheets, Google Analytics, Mixpanel, Amplitude, and Slack and Microsoft Teams. To connect an integration, go to the Connect tab in your survey view, and then find the tool of your choice. Let's add Google Sheets as an example. So this integration allows you to export survey results in real time, and you can also access your survey data from a selected sheet. So once we click here, we add our accounts, a pop-up window will appear where you just log in. And then you can choose to create a new sheet or connect to an existing one by simply copying the URL. But you will need editor permissions for that sheet. Okay, you can choose to send past responses as well. Here we have a convenient button to view the sheet. And you can also disconnect it at any time. Other tools like Mixpanel and Amplitude allow you to send survey results their way as well. You will have to have the API installed on your website first, but this works with all survey types. You can create cohorts of either satisfied or dissatisfied users, and you can track down user activation or behavior among those groups to understand what made them answer a particular way. Personally, one of my favorite integration is the Slack integration we have. It works very similarly to Microsoft Teams, if that is the team management system you are using. Connect these tools for very convenient notifications about responses. You can send answers from your survey to a selected channel or set up custom notifications. So we'll toggle this, choose a channel that we would like to send our responses to, and then we can set up the custom condition for Slack notifications. So for example, question and answer, let's select the satisfaction question as we did before, and let's just be notified about the unsatisfied customers. So 1 and 2, save. Even if you don't use a team management system, you can enable our email reports or notifications. So if you'd like to receive daily, weekly, monthly summaries with your survey results, let's set up an email report. So this would be an overall summary of the answers your survey received in a chosen period of time, as well as a sample of some questions and the answers provided. So you set this up in the Analyze tab, you go to the Email Reports tab and choose the delivery frequency, let's say daily. If you ever want to stop receiving those notifications or those email reports, just set the frequency to never. And this is what you can expect a report to look like. You have some samples of the answers, and you also have a direct link back to your Analyze tab. Okay, and if you want to receive email notifications, you go to the Connect tab and find our email notifications integration. And if you set this up, you'll get a notification every time you get a response, unless you set up some custom notifications, some conditions, and then you'll only obviously receive answers that match that criteria. So let's set up a custom notification. I'll just add in my email address to make sure I actually received a notification. And let's just choose the same condition as before, the satisfaction question, and the answer between 1 and 2. Save. And the custom notifications were set. So let's just answer this survey for fun with this condition. So let's say 1, I am very unhappy, submit. And then I go to my email app. And I just received a new email from Survicate, and this is my response. You can export your survey results at any time. You have a convenient button down here for CSV and XLS formats. You can either wait for the email with the link, or it should pop up just now. And you can download it right from the Survicate dashboard. And if you want to, you can download charts for a particular question. So let's download a PNG and PDF. Oh, by the way, in 2023, Survicate is planning on enabling PDF reports. So you'll be able to download your entire survey report in PDF format.